Hey everybody, Ann here, sitting on my porch, having my coffee with all of you. Today's video, I'm just going to talk about something. Well, I came across a video that talked about something that is near and dear to my heart, and that is puppies. See these two cute little guys? Well, they are my new puppies. Sunny is on the right, Junior is on the left, and they bring me hours and hours of entertainment and enjoyment. They are so sweet and playful and harmless. The thought of something bad happening to them just really worries me, especially if that harm may come on purpose. And you know what? There are people in this world who will take beautiful, innocent little creatures like this and harm them on purpose, all in the name of medical research. The video that I found comes from a guy that I follow. He talks about news and financial information and stuff like that. I don't normally follow channels that do that, but I really like this guy, so I watch him quite a bit. Well, he informed his viewers today that Dr. Fauci, who is the, I'll put the his actual title up there, but he is the health advisor to President Biden. And as it turns out, well, he is a disgusting piece of, I'm not going to say garbage, because he allows funding of taxpayers' dollars to puppies. Now, I'm not going to get into the details of what exactly he did. I'm just going to grace over the surface, and then you can go and research yourself and find out the things that he actually did. But it is a disgusting thing, and I think everybody needs to know about it, and we kind of need to pull together and figure out a way to make sure this stuff stops happening. It's been happening for years and years, and it's still going on. So what did Dr. Fauci do? Well, he runs an agency that does animal testing on cute little beagle puppies. They choose beagle puppies because they're sweet, they're docile, they don't usually bite. And so I'm not going to explain what they did to these puppies. You can do your own research. Just Google Dr. Fauci puppy scandal and you will find all the information you need. The White Waistcoat Project is the one that uncovered multiple times that this agency ran by Dr. Fauci has used taxpayers' dollars to basically do the most horrible things to not only puppies but cute little monkeys. And it is just so disgusting that I can't even leave the link to the initial expose on all of this. You're just going to have to find it yourself. One thing I will tell you that they did is they removed or damaged, took out the vocal cords of these sweet little puppies in order to make it a more amenable environment for the scientists so they didn't have to hear the horrifying cries and screams of these beautiful little creatures. Yeah, it takes a special kind of evil person to actually be able to do this. I don't know where they find these people. I mean, they've got to be the most soulless, heartless, black-hearted people on the universe to be able to conduct these kinds of experiments on God's creatures. The good news is one of our Congresswomen, Representative Mace, wrote an open letter to Dr. Fauci demanding answers. And so I'm going to talk a little bit about that now. She writes, "Dear Dr. Fauci, we write with grave concerns about reports of costly, cruel, and unnecessary taxpayer-funded experiments on dogs commissioned by National Institute of Allergy and Infectious Diseases." Then she goes on to detail some of, you know, her thoughts on it and the price tag, $1.68 million. Oh my goodness. And I blocked out some of it. You can go read the rest or stop the video and read it. But she makes some very good points. She then goes on to state, "While documents state that the ostensible purpose of the study was to provide data of suitable quality integrity to support application to the U.S. Food and Drug Administration, blah, 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 that the FDA does not mandate that human drugs be studied in dogs." Interesting, isn't it? She then goes on to ask her questions. I'll leave a link below so that you can read them all yourself. And the good thing is she got many of her political colleagues to sign in agreement. So that's great. I decided to find out which news media are covering this story, and precious few liberal media sources, at least not really super big ones, are following this story or talking about it at all. Oops, look it, There's Washington Post. Oh my gosh, I can't believe that a liberal media source is actually talking about this. But article after article, mostly conservative news outlets are covering it. So I decided to go look up and see what was on the major news networks, MSNBC. Nothing at all. This is their main page. I scrolled and scrolled and scrolled, and they did not mention a single thing about it, which is kind of disheartening. But you know what? It's totally expected. What does CNN have to say about this issue? Well, they're too busy bashing President Trump to, like, expand their coverage to how President Biden's medical advisor is totally letting puppies be, well, you know. But CNN has nothing to say about it. Surely CBS News has something to say about this, but nope, just keep scrolling and scrolling, and they have absolutely nothing to say on this issue. Doesn't surprise me at all, but oh, look at this next story. Little kids lined up, and FDA advisors set to meet on Pfizer's COVID vaccine for kids 5 to 11. Oh, can't help but wonder if dogs, puppies were used to experiment the COVID vaccine. What does ABC News have to say about it? Nothing at all. I kept scrolling and scrolling. Yeah, they're too obsessed with gun control to step outside the box and talk about other issues, you know, aside from taking guns away from people or, you know, bashing former President Trump. Yeah, whatever. What about PBS? Well, need I say more? Nah, they're not going to talk about it. They talk about some other things. I used to follow PBS until, you know, just the hatred towards conservative people or independent voters, independent thinkers. But nope, they don't have a single thing to say about this issue either. Anyhow, for any of you people out there speaking in support of Dr. Fauci or in support of medical research on animals to gain whatever results, well, I am totally against you. You don't need to have a voice at all. I want you to go away. Don't leave comments because I will delete them. You know, you may say, but Anne, look at all these wonderful medical things we've learned as a result of beautiful animals. Well, I will just tell you that I would rather die than have one single puppy or a cute little monkey or any of those kinds of animals, any animals at all, in order to advance medical research. There's other ways to do it, and we can't use beautiful living creatures to be able to do this. So, you know, if you're going to come on here and try and justify this practice to support, you know, your wellness, well, just go. Go somewhere else. I don't want you here. I don't want to hear what you have to say because you are as evil as the people who allow this to go on and take money from us in order to do it. It just boggles the mind. It really does. You know, I shouldn't watch the news because I get all worked up. Anyhow, you know, like I said, I don't think I said it. I think I said it and I cut the clip because I fumbled with my speech because I do that first thing in the morning unless I've had all my coffee. Anyhow, it's not just him. There's been other medical directors, people way high up in the food chain of the health industry who have allowed this same thing to occur. And it's not a Republican issue. It's not a Democrat issue. This has been going on for a very long time, and I'm just sick of it, you know. And it's been going on with conservative or Republican administrations, Democrat administrations. So it's not just Biden. It's not just Fauci. It is the whole industry. And people just like to turn a blind eye. I mean, maybe I have for a while because I don't follow the news a lot. You know, I was having a conversation with somebody about this. And they said, why do they use puppies? Why don't they just gather up the drug addicts, the meth heads, the crack hoes, the drunken people bent over, heroin addicts on the street? Why don't they just gather them up and test them, you know, and do the things that they were doing to these animals, to those humans, because they're not, you know, offering anything to society other than being a drain on society. Well, you know, I can understand the reasoning of this person who said that. Because, yeah, I dislike drug addicts and crackheads and meth heads and heroin addicts just as much as the next person. You know, they do drain society. They don't need to be here. But they are also God's creatures. So God doesn't want us to just have either. You know, that's just as inhumane. But, you know, I think it was said to me kind of tongue-in-cheek. But it does make you think. Why are they taking beautiful, lovely creatures who are man's best friend and not... and extinguishing their lives and not extinguishing the... Oh, gosh. Romeo's trying to get after one of the new girls anyhow. And why not extinguish useless drains on society? Well, because they're God's creatures. So that's my soapbox speech for the day. I'm just all worked up about it. Just seeing the photos. And if you... don't want to be disturbed, don't research this, because you will be disturbed. It's not nice. It's not pretty. It's just really gross. So, anyhow, this has to stop. We need to figure out a way, you guys. That's all I got for you guys today. See you in the next video.
For watching, everybody. I hope you enjoyed the video. Make sure you like, subscribe, hit the bell, and y'all have a good one.